They're stronger than us.
I've discovered a new species.
They're faster than us.
He's not a human.
They're more evolved than us.
There are thousands of them out there.
They hunt us.
We'll all die.
Prey, coming up next on Sci-Fi. Evolution sucks.
Evolution, natural selection. We've all heard these phrases our entire lives, but how many of us have ever really understood what they mean or thought about their implications? Next slide.
Suspect Randall Lynch, white male, age 32, 5 feet 10 inches tall, 175 pounds, shoulder length brown hair. Suspect Lynch is wanted in connection with multiple murders and rapes.
This is Detective Peterson. Look, there's nothing here. Lynch must have gotten through the perimeter. And I want to know where that hole is. Unit 1, what you got?
Unit 1, negative contact.
Unit 2.
Unit 2, we've hit a grate. We're turning back.
Unit 3.
Unit 3, we got nothing.
Wait a minute. I see something moving.
Let's take a look at what happened to Homo neanderthalis. Neanderthals were the undisputed masters of their environment for over 300,000 years. They must have thought that nothing would ever stand in the way of their dominance.
Yeah, Unit 1, come in.
Unit 1 here. Over.
Until we came along.
Ray! Ray, where are you, Ray?
Next thing you know, Neanderthals were gone. Why? Because two species cannot occupy the same ecological niche at the same time.
Come on, do it. Come on, you just pull the trigger.
From the dawn of time until today, a single biological imperative has ruled every species that has ever existed on this planet.
That's why you'll never win.
Survival of the fittest.
First wave. Buried alive.
You were buried in a subway tunnel.
Francesca was the subject of an alien experiment.
There's more of us. Save the others.
But will Kay discover the truth about these albino anomalies?
I will release no more evil.
First wave, a Sci-Fi original series. Tonight at 10 on Sci-Fi.
Research.
Absolutely.
So I'll be needing complete confidentiality.
Absolutely.
Sorry, I'm late, Ann.
That's all right.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'll be in touch. Hey, Ed. How's it going?
Fine. You know, Coulter's looking for you.
I know. I've got a prepper for court, but I promise I'll be back in time to go over last week's DNA differential report with...
It's okay. They're finished.
Finished?
Stayed up all night. Kinda got on a roll.
Ed, you're amazing. I owe you one.
I'll see you.
Y'all ready for court, Sloan?
Absolutely. Got the files right here. Randall Lynch. Raped 3 women, killed 5 men in the course of a week. Our DNA analysis has positively linked him to each victim. Nice when they make our work so easy.
I wouldn't categorize anything Lynch does as easy.
What does that mean?
Let me ask you something. Did you notice anything distinctive about Lynch's treatment of his victims?
Other than the fact that he severed their heads?
Only the men. Don't you think that might be significant? Let me ask you this. Why do you think he was so careless? He must have known the DNA would link him to the crimes. What does that tell you about his actions?
I don't know. That he wanted to get caught?
Or that he just didn't care?
As an expert in the study of DNA, have you formed an opinion within the bounds of reasonable scientific certainty as to whether the defendant, Randall Lynch's DNA, matched the blood and semen samples taken from each victim?
I have.
And what is that opinion?
In each instance, the DNA samples taken at the scene of the crime matched exactly those of Randall Lynch.
I could have told you that.
Randall.
Mr. Lynch.
And what is the likelihood that the DNA that you study could have come from any individual other than the defendant?
Statistically, about 1 in 11 billion.
You don't know me.
Maybe I do.
Mr. Lynch, one more outburst and you will be removed.
So, Dr. Coulter, in your professional opinion, there is no one else who could have committed these crimes.
That is correct.
Your witness.
You think you've proven something? You know nothing about me.
Hey, let's move the defendant. Barry, get
him. We'll all die.
Get him out.
Anne, what is going on? You will all die?
My guess is he means it.
Seems like more than a guess. It looked like you expected everything that happened. You practically dared Lynch to come after you.
Let's just say I wasn't surprised.
Come on, Anne. You've been evasive about Lynch all day. What's going on?
I've made a discovery about Lynch. There's a genetic anomaly in his blood.
Sorry to interrupt, but we have a problem.
Don't we always?
I need some of your time. I'm sorry to be a pain, but we are down to the wire on this CDC grant application. Without the two of us going over these numbers, I am never going to get it in.
Does it have to be tonight?
Deadline is midnight. I've already gotten one extension. We do this now or we don't get the grant.
Duty calls.
What was that all about?
I'm not sure.
Grab a coffee?
gotta work.
No, you look like you need some air.
She was completely unfazed. And then when I asked her about it, she said, let's just say I wasn't surprised.
Wait, what are you saying? You think Anne knew Lynch was gonna go after her?
It was weird. She didn't even bat an eye.
What is that about?
She was about to tell me when Dr. Atwood interrupted. She said it had something to do with his DNA. Did she ever say anything to you about that?
Sloan, please. She didn't tell you, she didn't tell anybody.
Yeah, I guess. So, what are you up to tonight?
I think I'm gonna hit a movie. Do you want to come?
I wish. I gotta head back to the lab. I gotta make up for the day I lost in court.
I'll see you.
Where's Bob?
Don't know.
Whatever. Did Dr. Coulter leave yet?
Nope. She's the only one still here.
Thanks. Cage, huh?
And James is out.
James, come on. You know you're not supposed to be out of your cage without your leash. Calm down. I'm not gonna bust you for this.
Is 2 inches thick, but it's busted clear out. It's the only way the killer could have escaped.
It's two stories up.
I know, but he didn't go by the guard, and there's nothing on the security tape.
Check the hospitals. Maybe he broke a leg or something. Dr. Parker. I'm Detective Ray Peterson. Do you think you can handle a few questions?
Do you have to do this right now?
It's okay.
I'm real sorry you had to be the one who found the body.
She's not a body.
I understand you were close to Dr. Coulter. Do you have any idea who might want to do this to her?
Besides Randall Lynch?
You're my first choice, too, but he's already in jail.
No one would want to hurt Anna.
You sure? I mean, there's no one in the lab who
Dr. Peterson.
That's me.
Tom Daniels, FBI.
I don't remember calling in the feds.
You didn't.
Dr. Coulter had been doing some classified research for us, and I'm here to make sure that data isn't compromised by your investigation. I'll have to take her files with me back to the Bureau. No offense.
Okay, just let me finish up here.
Don't you think maybe the rest of your questions can wait till tomorrow? Looks like Dr. Parker's been through enough for one day.
All right. We can pick it up tomorrow if there's anything else. Thank you, Dr. Parker.
Is there someone who can drive you home?
Yeah, I can.
Good. You get some rest.
Agent Daniels? Thank you.
Let's get out of here.
I'm sorry, Sloan. I really am.
Anne was the reason I came here. Why I'm doing what I do.
She was a great teacher.
She was my friend. She was almost a mother to me.
Remember 5 years ago when we first met her?
After class and corrected one of her lecture comments.
I cannot believe you did it.
Hey, you would have done the same thing. I just beat you to it.
See, Anne saw something in you, Sloan. You were not just another promising scientist. I mean, look at the way she confided in you. And even today.
I'm just gonna miss so much not having her to turn to. Los Angeles, please. FBI? Tom Daniels?
I really shouldn't be letting you see Dr. Coulter's files. The classified material hasn't been removed yet.
I really appreciate it. Anne's notes were important to my research.
Take your time. So, Dr. Coulter was your mentor?
That's right.
That's a good thing to have?
What?
A mentor, that's a good thing.
Right. I was lucky to be in the same room as Anne.
She felt the same way about you. She spoke of you all the time. She had a lot of respect for you.
Really?
Why do you sound so surprised?
Didn't know that Anne talked about me.
Actually, I feel like I know you quite well.
Well, then you have the advantage.
Maybe we'll get a chance to close the gap. Is everything okay?
Yeah. Everything's fine. Ed.
Hey. I thought you said you were gonna take a couple days off.
I was, but I went to the FBI today.
Why?
To get Anne's files on Lynch. Supposedly, Anne was doing classified research for the FBI, but when I went there, all her files on Lynch had been deleted.
So
Anne's doing research on Lynch. All her research data on him is gone, and now she's dead. Don't you think that's weird?
Sloan, come on. If there's a connection, don't you think the cops would have figured it out?
Well, I think Lynch had something to do with Anne's murder.
I'm sure they've already questioned him.
Well, maybe that's not enough. Thank you for meeting with me.
No, thank you.
Cigarette?
Clever. You want a DNA sample from my saliva. What happened to the sample you had?
I need a new one.
I can't imagine how hard it must be for you to talk to me.
After all,
you think I had something to do with the tragic death of Miss Coulter, don't you?
Well, did you?
How could I?
You tell me.
If you haven't noticed, I've been detained. Are you scared?
No.
You should be.
You don't frighten me.
You think you can stop the inevitable? You think bars and chains are going to keep you from dying?
I think they'll keep you where you belong until they execute you.
Is that what's going to happen?
I'm told it's very painful.
Will you be there to watch?
If they'd let me, I'd push the plunger on the needle.
I'd like that. We're done here.
You're dead.
For subject Lynch.
File opened.
Extract and analyze the DNA of base subject Lynch.
Analysis complete.
Compare base subject Lynch to other known samples.
No match in comparison.
Compare the sequence of nucleotides of the Lynch sample to all known ethnic populations.
There is no match.
Run the DNA sequence differential program for all samples on file, including subject Lynch.
Analysis complete.
Is there a DNA differential between me, Sloan Parker, and Ed Tate?
No, an exact match.
Is there a DNA differential between Sloan Parker and a chimpanzee?
Yes, 1.1%.
So far, so good. Compute the DNA differential between Sloan Parker and Randall Lynch.
1.6%.
Repeat analysis.
1.6%.
Repeat analysis.
1.6%.
Not human.
Okay, coming!
Sloan, open up!
It is 3 in the morning.
Ed, what I'm about to tell you, it's gonna change your life.
I like my life.
I've discovered a new species.
Of what?
Of us.
Sloan?
Coulter was doing research. I think she was about to figure it out. Read it. Tell me I'm wrong. I thought maybe the DNA samples had been contaminated. I tested it. I turned those samples upside down. Ed, it's not human.
1.6% different than us. Definitely not human. It took an ice age to cause the last speciation. Now, unless I miss something in the morning paper...
Environmental disruption, exactly. I'm thinking global warming.
That's only a 2 or 3 degree change. It's nowhere near enough.
Why not? What if it's more? What if the warming has occurred over the past 100 years and not the past 10 or 20?
This could be huge. Unless it's an isolated event. We need other samples. Lots of them.
We can start right now. We've got reciprocal deals with most of the big labs. I'm sure they'll help out.
Wait. Isn't that too narrow a test group? All the samples will be criminals.
Hey, that's where Lynch came from.
Yes, hi. I'm Dr. Sloan Parker. I work with Dr. Coulter. That's right, Ann Coulter.
No, that's perfect. Whatever you got.
It was a terrible shock. Thank you. Look, I'm following up on some of her unfinished work. I understand you have some DNA samples.
A blood or hair sample would be fine.
Whitney University in Pasadena. That's right. Thank you.
No.
They're emailing it over to the lab. It'll be there by tonight.
Great. I'll be on hold.
Coming.
Hi. I hope I'm not interrupting anything. I wanted to give you these. Dr. Coulter's files from her computer. We're through with them, I figure, since you were closest to her.
Thanks.
I was thinking, maybe we could talk about Dr. Coulter.
Sure. Come on in.
You have a very nice home.
I like it. I don't get to spend enough time here, but...
Reflects your personality. Very warm. Your sister?
Yes.
Much older than you, right? She a scientist also?
No, she's a nurse. She's got the hard job in the family.
How you feeling, Sloan?
Okay, I guess. Doing the best I can. Thanks. So, have you gotten anywhere in your investigation?
Not yet, I'm afraid to say. But, we're doing the best we can.
You said you wanted to talk to me?
Yes. I was hoping you would continue the work Dr. Coulter was doing for us.
If you don't mind my asking, what exactly was the work she was doing for you?
DNA research, particular study involving a certain limited sample size. It's complicated. I mean, for me, it's complicated.
I'm flattered.
She told us that she hoped you would follow in her footsteps. And I guess I do, too.
Not without your help. I'm gonna need her files on Randall Lynch. The other day in the lab, I noticed they were missing. I'll check these again, but...
Anne was right about you. You're very sharp.
So about those files?
I'm sure you understand you have to sign on first. Look, maybe you just need some time to work through everything that's happened to you. I'm sorry if I've pushed you.
No, that's okay. It's just everything that's happened this week.
No, I understand. Look, here's my number. You can call me anytime, even if you just want to talk.
I'd like that.
Okay.
Hey, you ready? I guess not.
Look, I don't want to hold you up. Think about it. Okay? Excuse me.
Ready?
Yeah. Twice
12,000 samples downloaded and ready to access.
Read sorting by hand.
Ready.
Correlate and mark each new sample for identification.
So, what did that FBI guy want?
Someone to continue the work Ann was doing with them.
This being the same FBI you think deleted her files?
He explained all that.
And they always have an explanation.
Samples marked.
Search for samples that match the base subject, Lynch.
So what's he like?
Who?
Secret agent, man.
There are 5 matches with subject Lynch.
Lynch has company.
Verify these findings with the phylogenetic analysis program.
Please provide a name for the new species. Please provide a name for the new species. Provide a name for the new species.
Man.
Never a dull moment.
No kidding.
Sloan, you know that we gotta tell somebody.
What? How? What are we gonna say?
I don't know, but...
Look at Darwin. He waited 22 years before he had announced his theory of evolution.
Sloan, it's a new species. We're not just talking about Lynch anymore. There's 6. How many more are there? And are they all killers like Lynch? Sloan, what you've done here is amazing. Anne would have been really proud of you.
I know. But why me? Ed, what's going on?
He got me.
Edward just said he wanted to see us.
I'll see you both now. Come in. Please, sit down. I know this is hard for you. I'm moving into this office, and it's with great sadness that I do so.
Does this mean that you're going to run the lab?
Yes. And if I can do half the job Anne did, we'll be in good shape.
So is that it?
No. We need to talk about Randall Lynch.
What about him?
Anne told me what she knew.
Why didn't you say anything?
Look what happened to Anne when she started telling people.
Anne was researching Lynch for the FBI. They know.
That's one of the things I'm concerned about. Anne was not doing research for the FBI. She hadn't even contacted them until last week. She wanted access to their DNA database.
Last week? But Tom Daniels...
Sloan, I'd be very careful. I think it's possible Tom Daniels knows a lot more about Anne's death than he's telling us. Ed, make sure you back up your findings to disk for safety's sake.
Miss, no one is allowed down there without an appointment. Will you stop, please?
I need to talk to Tom Daniels now.
What can I do for you?
I'm looking for Tom Daniels.
That's me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Daniels. Miss?
sample processed.
Mark it Tom Daniels.
The sample is marked.
Access all DNA samples, including the base sample for subject Lynch.
Accessing.
Calculate the DNA differential between Sloan Parker and Tom Daniels.
1.6%.
Oh my God.
I need to talk to you.
Ed, are you there? Pick up. If you're there, pick up, please.
No, no, just send the black and white over there, see what you can dig up. Yeah, I gotta go. So you're telling me that a guy posing as an FBI agent stole files from a police investigation, covered up evidence of a murder, and may actually have been an accomplice to that murder?
Yeah. And one more thing.
Okay.
I don't think Tom Daniels is human.
Not okay.
You're gonna have to trust me on this. It's what I do.
Let's define not human. What are we talking? Personality, eating habits?
His DNA. It's a different species of human, or technically hominid. It's evolution, Cro-Magnon, Neanderthal.
No, I know what evolution is.
It's not just Tom Daniels. Lynch is one also.
They look pretty human to me.
That's what scares me.
Okay, all right. I'll look into Daniels. Now, how about you go home? I'll send a couple of officers with you. You'll be okay.
I'm scared.
If any of what you just told me is true, you ought to be.
No, ma'am, I'll be right outside, okay? Mm-hmm. So there's no need to worry. You'll be fine.
Thanks.
This will be easier. Less painful.
You killed Anne.
No, I didn't.
Why did she have to die?
Because she was a threat to our survival. You know how evolution works? Homo sapien wiped out Neanderthal.
And now you're gonna wipe us out.
Survival of the fittest.
You don't have to do this. You're not a killer like Lynch. I know it. I know you.
No, you don't!
Then why did you leave your scarf here the other night? You knew I'd be able to get a DNA sample. You knew I'd be able to figure out what you are.
No.
You wanted me to know.
No.
You wanted me to tell.
No.
You could have killed me 100 times over, but you didn't.
It's because you feel things. Emotions. It's because you're different.
And you're different from those who sent you to kill me.
But you betrayed me. You told the police.
And you lied to me when I trusted you. Now we both know the truth.
There are others out there. Many others. If I fail, they'll still come after you.
Then I'll fight. Will they come after you?
Yes.
Will you fight?
Yes.
A short film is the best thing that you can do.
Sci-Fi gives the filmmakers of tomorrow exposure. A new original short film series, Wednesdays at 10 on Sci-Fi. Get exposed.